Hello everyone, and welcome back to more of Let's Play Phantasmagoria. Last we left off, we saw a rather brutal scene over in the greenhouse, and the game itself is going to rather start picking up pace from here on. So yes, we've gotten past the talkie-talkie portion of the game. But there's also this bizarre contraption over here. It's playing very evil music. Oh. And she's like, oh my god, what in the world is this thing? I don't even. Seems bizarre. Doesn't seem like it has any kind of practical purpose. But then again, I don't think 90% of the stuff in this house was meant to have a practical purpose. Doesn't look like she can figure out just what it is, so she's just gonna walk away from it. And rightly so. But, other than that, we also discovered this antique cameo brooch. And if you remember, Luann, when we first walked into her store, was talking with a client who was looking for 19th century cameos. So maybe she'd be interested in this. So I think that should be our next stop. Let's head on out. Down the stairs.
You dirty, rotten, stinking, filthy son of a bitch. You stay away from
Don.
My life. Just what are you accusing me of, sir? I know exactly what you're doing here.
I'm fixing the phone.
Don, shut up!
Oh. She got loud.
I think you better leave.
That's a good idea. I'm just gonna leave, like, right now. Why is Don getting so upset? He was the one who called to ask about the phone.
Tell me to shut up.
Yeah, fuck you too, Don. The chapter is finished. But now we're heading into chapter 5, and this is where things really start to go downhill. Well, in terms of the violence and mayhem, of course. But let the fun begin! Chapter 5, Friday, October 21st, 8:30 p.m. So it's the same day, just a little late at night, and it looks like Adrian's having a bit of a nap. Adrian? Are you gouging your eyes out again? Sweetie? I guess she was just having another nightmare. Are you okay, honey? Do you need some aspirin? Yes, it's 8:30. And for some reason, you wore your shoes to bed. I don't think that would be very comfortable. I've actually done that, like, once or twice, and it's really not that comfortable. Anyway, our laptop is open. What does it have to say to us today? What is going on? I thought I turned you off. Well, looks like your computer's crashed. Let's see if we can interpret this. Get. Out. Do not. Trust. Adrian, I think you should take the computer's advice. It seems to be the most sensible person in this house. And it doesn't even have a brain. Though then again, I'm not entirely sure you have one either. We'd need to do an autopsy to figure that one out. Let's head off to the observatory, because we have a painting that we need to look at. Let's see how far along it is this time. Oh. Looks like it's getting more detail. More stuff's getting filled in. Still can't really tell what it is, though. Nothing about it's determinative yet. She's just like, what is this? I can't paint. Who's painting this? I don't even. But we've never had a chance to wander around the house at night, so I think we should go take this opportunity. Oh. You've got some very interesting music playing. Let's head up to the attic room. Maybe we can find some interesting stuff up here. Anything in Malcolm's room? Let's see what the greenhouse looks like at night. Can't really see a whole lot. Still a nice view, though. Okay. Enough lollygagging. Let's see if anything's changed in here. Yes, go through the hole. Oh. What's wrong with the mirror? Well, only one way to find out, I guess. Uh-oh, cutscene. What do we have here?
No, the movie! Don't hurt us!
You never stop talking, do you? Never, ever. You just keep growing on and on and on.
Well, this looks legit. Sorry, I had to. So, I guess that's how that wife died. And again, she actually shows some common sense and flees from the room. But of course, we're gonna head right back in. I apologize for that. I don't know what happened there. The scene just seemed to skip. But you didn't really miss anything. She still ended up dead. Now, what do you think of this contraption, Adrian, now that you properly know it? I love it. She knows exactly what it is and what it's done, and now she's just like, eh, I don't really care. She just walks up to it, she's like, eh, walks away. I think after that experience, we need to go and check the rest of the mirrors in this house. Need to make sure they're not going crazy. Don? What you doing in there? Have you been seeing some strange stuff around the house tonight?
Don?
Go away.
You in there?
Adrian. Shock, he doesn't want to talk. Though granted, after what happened, I would basically never want to talk to him again. What about in here? Yep. We got a crazy mirror in here. Brace yourselves. This is actually probably one of the more gruesome scenes in this game. So if you're a bit squeamish, you might want to look away. Just give you that warning now. What is that thing in her mouth? Is that a funnel? Why do you have a funnel?
Tonight for you, a special feast, Regina. I prepared all your favorites. Doesn't this look delicious?
No, it doesn't.
For starters, giblets in a rich red marinara sauce.
Oh, lovely.
Sweet and sour tripe. Still hungry?
I was kind of hungry, not anymore.
Scrambled brains?
Lovely.
Yeah.
She's getting that brain food.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's killed her. Yeah. I will admit, even by today's standards, that's kind of Ugh. Yeah, I think that sufficiently lost me my appetite. Anything in Karno's room? Actually, you know what? We haven't checked, like, the ring or the cigarettes in a while. Let's go check them out. Anything new with the ring? Nope. It's still a ring. And she still won't take it. What about the cigarettes? I could really go for a smoke. Oh. One of the cigarettes is gone. Well. I think it's obvious who took it. It's obviously Harriet. I mean, it's not like we've seen any other scene with anyone smoking, and Harriet is obviously the most likely suspect. Speaking of which, let's go see what they're up to. I wonder what Harriet and Cyrus are. Oh. Well, there's Cyrus. What up?
There you are!
What is it, Cyrus?
It's Ma! She told me to tell you come to Dubon!
Why?
Wait! What for, Cyrus?
We having a party!
I think it has something to do with, the seance.
Oh, a seance.
Oh. Ooh. Okay, thank you, Cyrus.
And I love this. He got, like, that really, like, jaunty, happy music for, like, 3 seconds, and then it just disappeared. And I don't think we ever hear that music again at any point in the game. What is our fortune today? More death and doom. More death and doom. Oh. Yeah, that music is definitely not pleasant. She only ever picks up that one card.
We are watching you. You are not alone.
At least you still have your two hobo friends. Well, before we go out for that seance, let's go check out the absinthe, because we actually have been neglecting to do that for quite some time. Absinthe? Absinthe! She has to kneel down, get real close, go through this whole little thing just to get to this one bottle. Every time.
What is this? Absinthe.
What do you mean, what is this? You've looked at this for like 3 days. Why do you keep just saying, what is this? I don't know what's going on with that. But what's supposed to be happening is that during each day, the amount of absinthe in the bottle is actually supposed to be going down steadily, hinting that someone is probably drinking it. Ooh. What about the mirror in this room? Oh. And I always thought this made it look like the room was on fire for some reason. And although I kind of did the scenes out of order, like going from top to bottom, this was actually supposed to be the first scene you witnessed, which is why she looks more confused by it. Oh, there's a woman enjoying a drink at the table. Oh. Well, there's Zoltan, so I think we know how this is going to end at this point.
Well, well, look who's here. To my dear husband.
Well, someone's drunk.
Here's to you.
Ooh, she got some spunk. Oh! right through the eye.
No, here's to you, Victoria.
Ugh. That was lovely. Yeah. And also, she acts a lot more shocked over this death than the other ones. Adrian, I'm ready. Ow. And now she's sad. Though at least she's actually starting to have emotional reactions to crap. She's all better. Oh, I know where we need to go. We need to go into the cellar. After everything that's happened tonight. Down we go. We actually haven't been down here in a while. Oh. Hello. Oh, and there's crying. What's going on? No. Anyone in here? Hello? Are there more hobos living on my property?
Somebody in there?
Well, yeah. Guess it's just another ghost. Oh.
Somebody here?
Spooky hat. Those graphics were just... they're just amazing, aren't they? Guess no one's here. Out we go. Musical cue.
Oh god. It's just a rat.
Yeah, sure, that was a rat. And that's not the last rat we're going to be seeing in the Phantasmagoria series, but I don't want to even talk about that other rat. Ugh. But anyway, this casket's glowing. So, I don't think this really qualifies as a mirror, but, you know, let's see what it's got for us. Oh, and this was that casket that had the wine that we tried out, right? Yeah, that's not promising. What? Oh dear. Yeah. You drank, Victoria. So, if you couldn't tell what that was, the death that we just saw Victoria in there, that was essentially where she ended up. Because if you look at the genealogy book, they never found her body. So essentially what happened was Carno put her body into the grape crusher, and that barrel of wine was the result. And in fact, it's kind of quiet, but if you listen carefully enough, right as, like, Victoria or her head bobs into view, you can kind of hear the line that Carno said, you know, "No, he is to you, Victoria." It's just to kind of really drive it home. Yeah, and so, Adrian drank Victoria, and she thought she was delicious. Oh. But now we have to go to our seance. You have to have a seance in a horror game. It's a requisite. Oh god, no, Cyrus, just stop. No. I prefer you when your hair's matted.
Oh, Ma! She's here!
Where? What?
Welcome home!
Oh god.
Seeker of the spirit world!
Harriet, did you rob my wardrobe?
Please have a seat.
Alright, I'll play along.
Let the seance begin!
I'm overacting to the nth degree! You know what I like to do for fun sometimes, just look up the names of the actors and actresses from these old FMV games to see if they ever did anything else.
The Netherworld, heed us now.
Most of them, like, stopped after the FMV age. Some of them made it to, like, 2003, 2004, and then stopped.
Give us a sign of your spiritual being.
I think they're biting.
This one weighs like 10 pounds and it's a sea bass.
Oh, restless souls. This poor gal seeks answers. Answers to questions unknown. You just got to...
Oh. Harriet?
Oh, no.
Oh. Harriet, what did you eat? Jesus.
Oh, jeez.
She vomited up green goo. What has this woman been eating? I guess the rabbit they caught before was really, really bad. Face? Excuse me? Excuse me?
I, Zoltan Karnovac.
Zoltan?
Was greedy and foolish. And opened the door to the dark dimension.
That's nice.
I released some obscenity. An entity of pure evil.
The modern pop industry.
It had been contained. But now the pestilence is free to infect once more.
Your husband.
You are the chosen one.
What?
Only you can send it back.
Then I think we're in trouble.
Find the dragon. It will show the way.
The dragon. Okay. Karno, couldn't you have, like, gotten a more effective way to talk with me rather than Harriet's goop?
What happened? Where's Cyrus?
You don't know?
Know what?
Harriet, you did it! You really did it!
You're not pulling my leg now, are you?
No, I wouldn't do that.
That's never happened before.
So you've been lying to us.
Hot diggity! Oh! Cyrus! Cyrus! I did it! I really did it!
Yeah, Harriet, Cyrus knows. I don't think Cyrus wants to talk to you ever again. But that was fascinating. Ooh, I know. Let's go to town. Let's see what the nightlife is like here. I'm sure the parties must be outrageous.
Well, it's too late to go into town now. Everything will be closed.
But that's when all the crazy parties go on behind the scenes. Come on, Adrian, be one of the cool kids. But anyway, I think that's a good stopping point. So, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Phantasmagoria, and I hope you'll tune in for the next one. Alright, I'll see you all then.